Welcome back to News on the Hour. And aside from the protests in Osun State, we're also following up on another protest, this time on electricity tariff hike and, of course, petrol pump price increment in Nigeria. We're going to be speaking next with Mr. Achike Chude, the Vice Chairman, Joint Action Front, on a protest that took place in Yaba, Ojo-Legba area of Lagos State. Thank you so much for joining us, sir.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure.
Quickly share with us, you know, how the protest went. There are rumors that you were arrested.
Yes, we were. Actually, we had gathered at the NFC Secretariat at Olajuwon House at Yaba, and we had sufficiently mobilized enough people. And when we felt we had the numbers, we decided to move and sensitize Nigerians about our opposition to the increase in the pump price of fuel and electricity. You know, so we had gone beyond Ojo-Legba without any incidents, heading towards the Chire, somewhere along the line. You know, we were now turning back again, back to the NLC Secretariat, when a detachment of policemen accosted us, intercepted us, you know, and then so there was an altercation. They wanted to arrest the leadership of JAG, but every other person, there was resistance. And so the condition we gave was that if anybody had to go with the police, then it must be everybody that will be arrested. You know, and then we stayed there for quite some time, about 20, 30 minutes, because they didn't have enough men on ground to effect that kind of arrest until they radioed for, you know, backup or reinforcement. And then that came within minutes. And we are all now taking against our will to the area command, Nigerian police at Ojo-Legba. You know, so we are forcefully arrested. The way we got there, they spent actually time talking to us. I think they realized how precarious their situation was. And we made it clear to them that we are observing our fundamental human rights, you know, rights given to us by the Constitution. You know, but you know, the express to the usual worry, you know what they will tell you when they don't want you to do anything, that they did not want area boys to hijack the whole process. And we told them that the process had, we'd gone more than halfway before they accepted us, and then if there was any set of breakout in the violence, it was as a result of the intervention.
All right,
so we were there for quite some time and the outside, until they decided that we should be let go. But what we understand is that there were, you know, obviously instructions from higher up to tell them, you know, to get them to stop that protest. I think some people in government are jittering that a lot of Nigerians might get involved in such protests and express their displeasure about how they are being governed in that house. All those people that were outside, the bystanders, the civilians, were very happy, and they joined us in solidarity songs and didn't like what the police was doing.
I would get into that eventually, but I want to know if, you know, there were, if there was, of course, a message sent to the police before the protest took place.
Sorry?
Did you inform the security agencies before the protest took place?
No, I do not think we are required by law to inform the police. I mean, this is not the first time that we have been engaged in such a protest. We have a fundamental right, of course. But you know, the police arrested some of our people on Wednesday, at around the same place, because they were saying that they did not get the police permit, and we have made it very clear that we do not need police permits to do to gather in this country. It's a fundamental right of ours to do that if we want. You know, so they were saying that we didn't inform them so that they make sure that the hooligans do not take over the process. But we know that that is not the reason. They had instructions from higher up, because some people, obviously in government and within the police authorities, are worried about the precarious state of the economy, and perhaps that you know, more Nigerians might join such processes and express their displeasure towards government.
All right. Let's also talk about other unions. You're the vice chairman of the Joint Action Front. The other labor unions, I believe, maybe, you know, share the same views with you with regards to electricity and petrol price hike. But did you have other labor unions also present and in solidarity with you on this protest?
Well, you know, I might not talk about other unions, but I mean, your question, I think, is fair. We have been a major partner of the Nigerian Labour Congress for a very long time. In fact, the Joint Action Front, is the civil society component of LASCO. LASCO means Labour, you know, Civil Society Coalition. You know, and we have always been in partnership with organized labor. You know, but with regards to what is going on, we don't know why labor has not responded. But we have called labor, because that is their historical duty, to respond and do what they have always done on behalf, to take a position on behalf of the Nigerian people. Because the reality is that if they do not do that, then there is a perception that they are in support of that class that is oppressing the ordinary Nigerian. You know, but I understand that the PUC has also declared a day of action at the Trade Union Congress. If that is the case, we are all, you know, pursuing the same goals and the same ideas, then we will definitely show solidarity with the PUC.
All right. Achike Chude, thank you so much for speaking with us, and looking forward to having another conversation with you.
Thank you.